This is Jeremy Chapman reporting live from the Microsoft 365 Community Conference. Today we're going to talk about planner and project management and its infusion with AI. And I'm joined by Scott Van Vliet. Welcome.
Thank you, Jeremy.
So Scott, since we're at the conference, Microsoft Community Conference, what's the biggest aspect and kind of the best thing of the conference for you?
Well, I think the most interesting thing, Jeremy, has been the incredible reception to all the work we've been doing around Copilot and agents.
Okay.
You know, these last 2 years have been an incredible time for our company. Over our 50-year experience, the last 2 years have really been some of the most transformational.
Yeah.
And our customers and our partners are really showcasing that here at this community conference, both in terms of all of the features and capabilities we've shared with Copilot, but also specifically with the new agentic capabilities that we've shared, both in Jeff's keynote and what you're hearing from some of these breakout sessions. It's been remarkable to see not just how quickly we've been able to ship some of this stuff, but also how quickly our customers have been able to experiment and play with the capabilities, whether it's Copilot Studio and building their own agents, whether it's using the first party agents like Facilitator and the Project Manager agent. We've heard an incredible response from our customers about how these tools and these capabilities are already unlocking a ton of value for them and their businesses.
Right, and I can't believe how fast everything is going myself in terms of just, I think the new focus is really on quality, like the quality of the completions, the responses. It's just doubling, it seems like, every month or every quarter or something, but it's faster than I've ever seen. Being in IT and being in Microsoft for 20 years now, it's awesome being part of all of this.
No, it really is. I think the pace of innovation in the marketplace, both in terms of how quickly foundational models are getting more capabilities, as well as the speed at which our teams and our partners are reacting to that. You know, going from model shipping, you know, very, very quickly after the release from OpenAI, for example, and seeing that on Azure OpenAI and also within the M365 Copilot experience, it's been just phenomenal. I've obviously been at Microsoft for a while too, and just seeing the pace at which that stuff is happening, it's really kind of putting all of us in a position of moving fast and really pushing the edge of what these capabilities of these foundational models and then the agents that we're building on top of them can deliver.
So how's that then kind of transforming back into, because you've got all this project management planning to try to move as fast as possible, how is your team and all of what you're building kind of serving that as well in terms of just the back end of that in terms of making all these AI capabilities light up?
It's actually fascinating, right? Because you know, Microsoft has a history of building products over many, many years. We're 50 years this year, and now in our 51st year. And we've gone through lots of transformations, whether it was initially shipping CDs, I'm sorry, shipping software on disks.
I remember those.
To then moving it to CDs and DVDs, and then obviously delivering software continuously in the cloud. In this world of AI, whatever plans that we've been thinking about, whether it be a semesterly plan or a yearly plan, these things are often getting upended. And so for our team, who's building project management tools like Planner and the Project Manager agent, we've had to leverage those tools ourselves to stay ahead of this kind of ever-changing roadmap, if you will, of new capabilities and new features that are emerging from these foundational models. And so for us, the thing that we've turned to is the products that we're building.
Right.
You know, we recently talked about the Project Manager agent in the keynote with Jeff and also in some of our breakout sessions. And the Project Manager agent is this new agent that exists inside of Planner that allows you to set goals, generate tasks, and even complete some of those tasks on your behalf with the agent, and also do things like generate status reports.
Yeah.
So it's been fascinating for us as we compare the baselines of the work plans that we have for building some of these agentic features and trying to report out on the status of those features. We're actually using these tools to reduce not just the drudgery, but also increase the speed and velocity at which we can understand, like, okay, 2 weeks ago, we said we were going to do this. Some new capability came out of Copilot Studio. Some new capability came out of the core LLMs. How does that change our plans?
Right.
And our ability to adapt is really made possible because we're leveraging these tools internally to make it work. So it has been a change. And I think I've talked to a lot of customers here at this conference. But they're also going through that kind of pressure of what do these tools mean for them. And it's been really cool to partner with some of these customers who are early adopters and get their feedback because they're also going through some of this you know, rapid transformation themselves.
Yeah, totally. It's great to see that. So how do you see the integration then? Because there's a lot of different kind of app endpoints and different paths into, say, Planner and project management tools. How do you see that integration kind of working depending on like where people prefer to work, what they're outputting in terms of the file types, formats? Is that getting better in terms of like, does the AI story get better there and the integration story get better there too?
No, it definitely does, Jeremy. So last year at the same event, we announced the unified new planner. which was us taking the project for the web application, the planner application, and to-do, and bringing those all into one product to simplify kind of how tasks and work management and planning was done across the M365 ecosystem. Got really great customer response from saying, finally getting your stuff together and getting us one product.
So now a task is kind of the same task everywhere it turns up.
Yeah. So we've solved for that. But what's interesting is you can't just expect that all of your customers are going to go to your application when the flow of their work might be inside of a Teams meeting or inside of a Loop document or, in this case, a Copilot page. And so what we've done is create integrations across all of those canvases.
Yep.
So for example, inside of a Loop page or inside of a you know, a notebook inside of Copilot, you can actually insert a task list control. And that task list control or Loop component is actually synchronized to your to-do list inside of Planner. So if your flow of work happens to be inside of Copilot and you're generating a list of tasks, you can synchronize that back into Planner and it's available for there, available for you there, whether you're using the Planner app or even if you're using Planner in Teams. It's all in that one location. What we've also done is integrate those capabilities into things like Teams meetings. So AI-powered notes that you've seen inside of meeting notes on Teams, that's also powered by the same task backend that we run inside of Planner. So your meeting tasks are going to show up there. And so what we're really focused on is saying, like, hey, we want to first get you all of the capabilities you need for work management, no matter where you are in your flow of work. And then you can use the power of the project management agent, the project manager agent inside of Planner to really kind of supercharge the work you're doing across all those canvases.
And everybody can interact with it in real time. All of those changes are replicating across all those endpoints because it's still the same shared component underneath, the same shared set of tasks effectively. So okay, so from your kind of leadership vantage point, our approach to task management, how does it kind of reflect the broader vision then for like AI-powered collaboration in general across Microsoft 365? What are we going to maybe build in the next couple of years to make things even better?
Yeah, well, I think you've seen the Work Trend Index that Jared's team had put out, and it talks about this kind of frontier firm and the different phases that we're on from kind of the initial human and the co-pilot together, you know, making things possible, then human and agents working together, and then this kind of agent-boss scenario.
Yeah.
I think for us in the world of Planner and, of course, across the collaborative apps and platforms teams, we're really thinking about that orchestration of agents getting your work done for you. Right, and so if you think about the experience that we showed in the keynote, it's not just about like, okay, generate a status report or do some of the things which are super useful. We're actually saying like, hey, we're gonna help you build a plan and then actually execute those tasks for you on your behalf.
Yeah.
So whether it's like, okay, I'm gonna go launch a new marketing website for a new product campaign, actually going out and generating the body copy, generating the images, let's say that's a set of tasks, you can actually sign that to the project manager agent and it'll go get that work done for you.
Right.
And so in this idea of moving from kind of that retrieval or assistive technology that we're seeing in the early phases of Copilot to going to that full, it's a digital colleague that's available 24/7 that does work on your behalf, but what it really does is keep the human at the center of the experience.
Right.
And that's a key thing for us is that even if you look at the experience of project manager agent today, we'll go and generate a document for you, images, but then we bring that back for you for your review, and you can actually make edits inside of a Loop control. You can make edits or give comments and do regeneration because we want the humans to be at the center of the experience. And so we're really thinking about that agent boss concept from the Work Trends Index and really supercharging you and your productivity with all these agents around you. So as we project to the future, it's really about what types of agents exist that can do work on your behalf? How does that surface across all these canvases? And we're really just scratching the surface with what we've shown our customers and our partners so far. And I'm pretty excited about some of the stuff that we've got cooking.
It's so great, because it's where I started at Microsoft, actually building task sequencers to install operating systems, drivers, apps, like all these things. We're doing this for like everyday work, where it can actually do these work items for you, and you're giving it, like we were doing then, the parameters of what it needs to specialize the work for that specific project or that specific thing that it's trying to do. So really, really cool stuff. So if you look at kind of all the collective tasks that your team has been doing throughout the event itself and kind of the planned tasks, the things that went well that were planned and unplanned across there, were there things that kind of surprised you along the way as you got prepared for this event itself and things that maybe didn't turn out or did turn out really well based on your planning with your team?
Well, certainly I'd say over the last year and a half, as we've been on this journey as a team to leverage AI and build experiences, We've certainly failed a lot. Tried things that didn't work and spent a lot of time working on things like our convergence projects and other activities mm-hmm. to only realize that some of these capabilities with these foundational models and with agents allows us to kind of do a step function skip, if you will, over some of the work that we've been doing and really unlocks some of the thinking, even in terms of how these agents can take diffuse problems and actually become more deterministic with agents. You mentioned in a previous conversation offline about how semantic kernel can orchestrate activities in one of the other videos you did. And in that model, you can actually take these agents and have them work together to really get an outcome that's more deterministic that you might get in a traditional algorithmic approach, but you're literally just using prompts and agents talking to each other to get a better outcome. So that's been something that's interesting for us as we think about like the project manager agent. It's not just one agent. There's actually over 70 micro agents, if you will, that are internal agents working behind the scenes to collaborate and work together to get better outcomes. And so that was a real surprise for us of leveraging not just the models to do like summarization and generation, but actually to use them as a core sequencer or orchestrator of the runtime, if you will, of our products. That was a big surprise for us that helped accelerate and propel our velocity in terms of feature development and capabilities. Again, we're still scratching the surface of this as an industry, and I think we're ahead because of the work that our partners in Azure OpenAI, our partners in the Substrate team here at Microsoft, as well as Microsoft Research and Autogen and all these cool things that are coming out have really helped us, but we're just scratching the surface of what can come.
And it just keeps getting, like I said, every quarter, every month, it keeps getting doubling. It's like Moore's law for intelligence of the responses.
That's right.
Keeping doubling all the time. So really, really great to catch up with all of this. So anything else that you'd give everybody who's watching right now as advice, like in terms of what to look forward to from a planner or project management perspective, what should they be doing and looking at?
Well, I certainly hope you give Project Manager Agent a try. You can find that at aka.ms/planner to find out more details about the Project Manager Agent and see how it can help you manage your workloads.
So thanks so much for joining us today, Scott. This is Jeremy Chapman delivering to you live, reporting live from the Microsoft 365 Community Conference. Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more content like this, and we'll see you again soon.